seabird. Going south on 59. Building them out here. I see cranes out here. So they're not completely done putting windmills up, turbines. Sign would have been sitting. And And then, oh yeah, what really pissed me off, it shows it's a two-lane exit, and in the middle of the exit, I mean, after you exit, completely exit off of 170, in the middle of the turn, before you get back to 70, you lose the left lane, and I jumped out there because, you know, hey, I didn't know, and yeah, and then nobody let me back in. Pissed me off. Why even have a two-lane exit if you're going to eliminate one lane halfway through the curve? Get a little rant this morning. Literally, I mean, they had a cop blocking, they had the ramps closed down, and they had a cop blocking the on-ramp from the traffic light, but that was it. They weren't telling you where you needed to go, so I basically just followed somebody else. What really irked me was because it had happened. When I got there, it was about 3:30. Apparently, it had happened like 3 hours before that. So, they've had the road closed down for 3 hours already. Why not put a sign up, clear back before I-255, saying that 70 was closed and you had to find an alternate route? I would have gone up 255, up to 270 if it went around, but I didn't know about the road being closed until I got on top of it. All it would have taken was, and then, of course, we get up to the traffic. While the traffic was slowing down, I switched over to Google, and it said road was closed due to an accident. That's all it said. If I had known that before I got to 255, I would have gone north on 255. I think I'm making a right turn here. Miles on the dirt road. Funny thing is that when I was going, before I got to 255, I had a funny feeling that something was going to happen, and I should have taken 255, but I didn't. That accident happened, it was just right before the 170. Well, I mean, that's where we actually got back on, was the 170. So it was two miles, I think it was 2 miles. Actually, technically, it was probably only about a mile and a half, 2 miles. I'd say 2 miles. 2 miles west, or excuse me, 2 miles east of the exit to 170 north, or 170 south. One crane will put all three columns up, actually you could have two cranes putting columns up. One crane put the last column up, then they raised the nacelle. Well, maybe not. I bet the nacelle is heavy enough that they only put it up with one crane, or put it up by itself. And then they'll attach the three turbine blades to the collar on the ground, and then raise all of that up as one assembly, and then attach it to the nacelle. The nacelle is the storage pack, I guess. What Sparky might call it. That way, when they do the three turbine blades to the collar, then they only have to pick the collar up instead of trying to pick up a blade and putting it up there. They're even building them. Oh wow, there's over here even on the other side, on the right side. I can't spin the camera that way. Parts back there, and there's some parts there, and a whole bunch of more. Now there's two more cranes on this side. See right there? I haven't started putting that one up yet. There's another one here. They're a mile away. But these roads wider so they can get the big trucks down them. around more. Things starting to rock around a little bit more. Thank you. funded it, shipped into the office.